Hey guys, I'm back for another video, and today I'm going to be teaching you guys how to fix high encoding in OBS. For those of you guys that don't know, high encoding means that your CPU is being overworked. You're at 100% CPU usage and OBS can't keep up. It doesn't have enough processing power to produce a full quality video. So what you have to do, this is very simple. If you have high encoding, there's a couple things you can do. The quickest and easiest solution is to make sure that, for example, if you're recording a game, that you have nothing open on your computer except OBS and the game itself. So there you go. So don't have like 10 Chrome tabs open. Skype is fine, doesn't really use a lot of resources. Try not to have any downloads going or Steam. But I'm going to be honest with you guys, this is a very temporary solution because chances are, at one point in the game, it's still going to go back up to 100% and you're going to be at high encoding again. So, to fix that, what you're going to have to do is go into your OBS settings. So, I'm using OBS Classic right now. If you're using Studio, it's the same idea, it just looks a little different. So, what you got to do is go to the encoding tab. As you can see right now, I have a bitrate of 8,000. Which works for me. I'm using an i7-6700K processor, and it is very easily able to handle 1080p 60 video at 8,000 bitrate, which is a little lower than I'd like it to be, but of course I'm using OBS Classic, which is not as efficient as Studio. So if you're still getting high encoding, what I would recommend is lowering this number. So if you're doing something like 720p, even 1080p, I would say the lowest you should go is 2000. If it goes below that, then your processor's not very strong. Chances are you're working with a laptop with an integrated graphics card, and there's really not a heck of a lot going on as far as specs are going. And if you want to pursue making videos, you're going to have to upgrade your hardware. That's the simple of it. But if you really want to get content out there with what you have, you can go really low. You can go to like 1000 if you like. And if you're doing something like that, I would recommend you go to 720p. Even at 2000 bitrate, I'd recommend 720p, because then if you go any higher resolution, it's just going to look really bad. In the top right-hand corner, I've got the link to the OBS Classic tutorial. If you haven't set everything up properly, I would highly recommend you go there first. And then if you're still getting high encoding, then try lowering that bitrate or resolution. And if you're using OBS Studio, here's a link for that as well. High encoding is horrible for recordings. This is something that you want to avoid at all costs. What it does is it turns your video into a slideshow in some cases, where the frame rate is literally like 5 if you're lucky. So, or at the least, it would just cause skips in the video. So I would highly recommend, there's anything that decreases the usage of the processor would help you here. Well, that's it for this video, guys. This is a very simple solution to a very common problem. If you have any other questions, leave them in the comments down below and I will answer you. But chances are, if this does not work, your computer is not powerful enough. Just to give you guys a benchmark, I am going to open up CoreTemp, which shows off some of my CPU stuff. So as you can see right here, I've got my i7-6700K Skylake processor. It is quad-core, and I'm currently clocked at 4.4 gigahertz. As you guys can see, even though I'm recording 1080p 60 video on a 1440p screen and downscaling it, I'm still able to get an average of like 15% load while recording. So, of course, this is going to shoot up when you open your game or whatever you're recording, whether it be Chrome or something. But, yeah, you want to be able to just check your stats here. Like, how's your load when you're literally just recording the desktop or, like, nothing really there? And as you can see, I'm maintaining decent temps right now. If you're still having problems and you want to comment down below, it'd be useful if you downloaded CoreTemp and then just gave me this number, or gave me maybe even just some information like what processor, what speed, and I'll be able to tell you if there's something up or if you just don't have powerful enough of a processor. Well, anyway, that is it. So I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys later.